going on? There we go. Why am I also this guy? Hello?
Hello. Sorry, still
okay.
I'm just trying to take this all in.
Yeah, no, it's my... My game's been acting funny, so I'm making sure I'm still here.
Am I selecting a perk here, or...?
Yeah, you can select your perk, set up your character, stuff like that.
I always do, like, support, although it might not be the best thing to just jump in with.
Support... are you talking about, like, killing floor support, or, like, a support class, because...
Sorry, I meant literally... Well, yeah, I suppose support or medic.
Medic is actually really, really cool in this game because healing is made a lot easier and their guns are actually really unique.
The thing is, I don't want to be something like too complicated, if you know what I mean.
That's fine.
As long as, like, being a medic's not, like, crazy. I can just be a medic.
Oh, that's not crazy at all. It's just, like, you have... Your weapons are the ones you can buy. It's like you start with a pistol, and then you can buy an SMG, a shotgun, and an assault rifle, and all of them just have like an all-fire that shoots a healing dart, and that's it.
Alright.
Nothing complicated, really. Like I said, this game is not easy. So like, I think last time I played with me and Yoshi, we actually had like mid-level characters, we still end up dying on this level on this difficulty, because it could be a little unforgiving.
Right. So. Oh shit, wasn't I thought there'd be like a setup phase?
Oh, no.
Oh god, that's not a... I don't have a crosshair, is that normal?
Yep.
Oh shit, that's really put me off.
Yeah, that's a killing floor one thing, and they retained it here. You can turn on a crosshair, and it's insanely vague and huge. Like, it's a big circle.
I think you've mentioned this before.
Yeah.
Any melee attack, or... Oh, a flashlight.
There is a weapon shove. I think it's default to V for whatever reason.
Okay.
Definitely rebind your keys at some point if you want to get used to this game. Because melee shove can be pretty useful.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, the V key I think is a pretty bad spot for it, so.
If you need like healing or something, I'll help you, but you might have to talk me through it.
Oh yeah, sure thing. I think healing is middle mouse button. With your melee, or your...
Oh, shit,
buttons.
Okay.
If you hear a little beeping noise as you aim at somebody with your medic weapons, then, Oh, let's go to the trader. Follow me.
The hell?
If you hear a little beeping noise...
This glass, I didn't realize.
Yeah, if you hear a little beeping noise when you're aiming with your medic gun, that means there's somebody that it'll auto-target onto.
Right.
If you hit the, middle mouse button, and somebody that actually requires healing.
I don't...
Guns are, they're just something you gotta get used to. Like, I would get the SMG, like the second weapon, I believe.
Oh, I just thought I'd get dual pistols. You know, go like John Woo.
I mean, it's not bad, but you already have a pistol with your default weapon, so.
So, what is this, primary? Oh, maybe I should have just been using that all along.
Oh, is that not what you were using?
No.
Really? Because you healed me with it, so...
I think that, yeah, when you said the middle mouse, it doesn't matter what I've got equipped. Or maybe it does. Okay, I'm confused.
It does, yeah. I think you were using it. Because, I mean, it's the default weapon you pull out.
I must say, lack of crosshairs really makes aiming down sights more important. What the?
Oh yeah.
What's making things slow down? Is that you or?
That is random. Random kills will cause that to happen, and certain classes are actually allowed to extend that time. As in this game, it's specifically the commando. But yeah.
Mind you.
Makes it kind of hard to be tactical with it, but
I've got your back, sort of.
I'll try to get yours, but bad spot, I think.
Yeah, we're both hush.
I'm gonna burn to death. NBD. Ow, asshole. Oh, nice heal. Thank you.
What the hell's shooting fire? Oh, this asshole.
Big orange dude over here, yeah.
I see what you mean about this being tough. Oh right, so I'm regenerating these. I was trying to work out what the limit was. I don't have much money. What am I doing wrong here?
The game's just very stingy.
Alright.
Like, generally you can't get your really big guns until like the 4th or 5th wave. If you're saving up and using your ammo very efficiently.
Right.
Also, lots of kills will get you a little bit of money, or a little bit more money.
I guess I'm just not going to buy anything this round. Like, I might as well save.
Yeah, yeah. No big deal.
Break time's over. Get back to work. This is really fast-paced. I seem to remember the first game, like, having a bit of downtime. Don't we have to, like, weld doors or something?
You can, but in this game, the doors, if they break after you weld them, they're permanently gone. So they're a lot less effective.
Right.
It's better to do on later waves so that you, like, you can kind of gather them up together. When they're, like, really scary, and then,
What do my med grenades do? Do they heal, or they just...
They heal and poison enemies.
Right. Good to know.
Everyone's grenade is unique in this game, as opposed to the first game where I think only the medic and the pyro had unique ones.
I'm just trying to take this whole lens.
Yeah. There's a lot of things I could explain, but I don't want to just, like, sit there and babble off information.
All of that, there's, like, a big pile of these black ones. And then one of them was alive.
Oh, jeez. Yeah, the crawlers are really annoying.
I've got to say, this is considerably better than the last game that used, like, the Unreal Engine, the 2004. I mean, it was a mod, wasn't it, originally?
Oh, yeah, yeah, definitely.
I can barely make out this glass. I'm just going to shoot it just so I can see it.
Oh, yeah, yeah, go for it. It's there to be shot. Or punched.
Right, I finally have a primary weapon.
We're almost out of time. Okay, hold on. Let me heal you up a bit.
Oh yeah, yeah, I should return the favor.
Nah, I'm healed. Don't sweat it.
Uh,
usually hold out in this one room, but it's not always that safe.
I'm just going to turn up my FOV just a bit. There we go. Yeah, that's better. I felt a bit like tunnel vision.
Oh, jeez.
God, this is a...
Alright, that's a big guy. He's really scary and really hard to kill, so...
Good to know. Whoa!
And,
Shit.
He might be...
Throwing you a...
No, I'll get over there.
If you get over here, there's a...
I'm standing in one of them.
Shit.
Yeah, those guys are super frustrating, because if you don't have a class really good at dealing with them, then,
Yeah.
They can wipe out entire teams. And he's not even the scariest guy.
Good to know.
That guy's gonna be the next wave. Also, I gotta say, your guy's a bit dramatic.
I've noticed. Well, he's from Chivalry, where everyone screams. It's, like, accurate. Shit, my armor. Yeah, he definitely sounds like he's from that game.
Oh, jeez, these stalkers.
Jesus Christ, man. Shit.
What's up?
I was hitting the back while I was trying to self-heal.
Self-heal is Q by default?
Yeah, I was like in the middle of the, in the animation.
Oh.
Shotgun, yeah, I could do with a shotgun. I've got more grenades to seem handy.
Oh, the grenades are super useful for medic, especially.
Oh, wait, how do I refill ammo?
There should be, on the right of the gun, there should be,
Yeah, I got it.
Bag and fill. Okay.
God, I just presumed that it would just be automatic, but nope.
Nah, you gotta choose. I mean, you get an autofill if you have enough money to buy for everything, otherwise it'll, buy a little of, everything as far as you can afford.
Well, at least I've got a shotgun.
Yeah, there's definitely an element of managing your own money here, where you don't want to buy ammo for guns you're not using, like your basic pistol, if you're not actually using it, or you don't want to fill up on ammo whenever you're saving up for something bigger.
Anything I need to know about the screaming one?
Grenades will be eaten up if she screams at them.
Huh.
So, if she's screaming and you have a grenade on the floor, not after it's exploded, like, yours will actually remain if it's already, like, emitted the smoke, but, yeah, don't throw grenades at her.
I'm also trying to conserve my ammo a bit more now I realize how limited it is.
Whatever your best weapon is, you want to save some ammo for it for the big dudes.
Right, okay. In that case, I'll switch to pistols.
Okay.
God, the invisible ones are fucking annoying.
Yeah, definitely. There we go, okay.
If you step back a bit.
I'm in my corner. I backed up like an idiot. Ooh! Ooh! Holy crap!
What's this, if I press middle mouse, with the scalpel, he just has weird grab? I can't tell what he's trying to do.
Oh, it's blocking. If you have a melee weapon, your all fire is a block.
Huh. Well, it isn't like chivalry.
And, the big guys, that's actually why berserkers are really good against them, because they can block their attacks and, cause them to kind of stumble back. Berserker is definitely my favorite class, so I have one maxed out already in levels.
Right. Is it leveling up like cross game?
No.
Oh.
As in like cross like session or cross like Killing Floor 1?
No. I mean like in this game, like is it like a progression system.
Oh yeah. It is. Okay. Yeah.
As opposed to say League of Legends, like if you're just leveling up. In game.
Oh no, yeah.
Right.
It's like I gained a level during this wave or during this game, and
that's cool.
My berserker's 25.
Yeah, the scalpel, that's a good idea. God, I spent that whole time just trying to juggle my weapons.
Yes.
God, this game's dark. I mean like literally dark, I can't see very well. Oh, I forgot.
Get behind you. Okay.
Oh, she's gonna eat up that grenade.
No. Not the one that's already out.
I'm gonna run around this. Oh, can't jump down there. So what are the other classes? I mean, I saw what they are, but I didn't really, like, take it in.
You've got Berserker, the all-melee slash semi-tank kind of guy. Medic, Support Specialist, who was the shotgun guy. Commando, who was the machine gun guy. Gunslinger, who's a pistol guy. Firebug, flamethrower weapons.
Alright.
And, what else is there? Oh, demolitions.
What do they do?
You got RPG launcher, grenade launchers, C4. And, certain enemies are weak to certain things, such as, the biggest, scariest enemy is weak to explosion damage, so demos, or actually Berserker, is really good at killing them.
Hmm.
Scrag is actually resistant to it. I think they're vulnerable to other things. So, it seems a little deceptive, but honestly, having a good variety of classes is actually a good thing. I've been kind of waiting for them to re-add the sharpshooter so that you can have somebody to snipe the fireball launcher guy. Let me get a medic pistol.
Are these, like, straight-up zombies in this, or, like, what's the backstory?
They're all mutant creations by some dude.
Sure.
I'm not too familiar with it, but I know that they're not zombies, they're an experiment of some sort.
Dweller.
More or less.
So when will people learn?
What's that then?
Well, just when will people learn, you know? Just stop making goddamn zombies.
No, these are the ultimate beings or some bullshit.
No, they're not. They fucking suck.
They're ultimately useless. If I remember correctly, from what Nimrod told me, apparently this game specifically centers around the people who ended up creating these things are like, oh shit, we fucked up. They hired a bunch of mercenaries to go and kill them all.
Huh. That isn't Bully. They did the exact same thing.
Huh. Fair enough.
It's like the mercenaries mode. Literally, it's literally called the mercenaries mode.
Oh yeah.
It's like Hunk and like some others. In fact, your guy could like pass for Hunk.
Okay, one's dead. Ah, that was gonna eat my grenade. I hate this lady.
I quite like the lack of crosshairs.
It's a nice feeling. Oh, come on, we can make it. We can make it to the boss. I think we did it.
Oh, not that one.
Damn. Honestly, not bad for your first game.
Hmm. The trick is to shoot the bad guys.
So this is the boss wave we're preparing for.
Oh god.
There are one or two bosses that can pop up. One of them is hard. The other is impossible.
I think I better fill up what I already have.
Have you got anything interesting you can buy? Go ahead.
No, I'm just shy of an assault rifle. Do I have to use weapons limited to my class?
No.
Huh.
I actually have a medic pistol on me.
Huh.
Because the medic pistol is actually extremely lightweight, so almost everyone can carry it alongside their normal builds. And since it has the healing dart, it's actually insanely effective to do so.
Right. How good's a grenade launcher? I can afford that. Or a flamethrower? Oh, shit. Never mind.
Yeah. I mean, all weapons are fine, but some are just much more effective when you have the perk benefits, although when you're level zero with everything, it doesn't matter that much. Also, yeah, this is the guy we're probably just gonna die to.
Oh. I didn't look that tough. Scarecrow wannabe.
Whenever he starts shielding himself, don't shoot him anymore.
Oh.
But, like, I'll tell you when that's happening. He has phases, and he switches between phases where he shields himself and then heals himself off of one of you.
So like that now, don't.
Yeah, yeah. So he's going to grab me. No, he's actually going to punch me because he's an asshole. And now he's healed up again, and this thus begins phase two.
Yeah, I thought I'd throw a healing grenade at you while he was
that's
doing that.
Time for it, yeah.
Ow, 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 I'm gonna die. Shit.
Yep.
I got kinda cornered.
Yeah, cornered is pretty much instant death in this game. This guy also has the downside of whenever he decides to start meleeing you, you're just going to die.
Good to know.
There's pretty much there's no way around it. Like, once he starts attacking you, there's a chance he will not stop.
Yeah.
You will just die. An insanely just infuriating stupid boss fight.
Well, that was fun.
Yeah. I like the game a lot, despite, you know, that guy. It's very fast-paced.
Fast-paced is right.
Yeah. The class class variety is there.
Dosh.
Dosh, yeah. They've embraced the hell out of their fake money?
Is this still set in England?
I believe so.
That would explain Dosh.
It's still very English, yeah. The different levels take place in different parts of the world, I think, because we got Paris over here.
That's part of England. Who said it's not?
You know, I wouldn't really even know, honestly. I'm so just geographically retarded that I can't even tell you.
I can tell you Paris is in France. That was a little joke.
But, as far as I'm aware, I don't think Texas is in England.
Yeah, it is. I live next door to you.
Oh, shit.
I'll wave out the window. Hi.
Hey. Just believe me that I'm waving at you. There's a bit of a downtime before it loads up the new map, but I think it's just because I'm hosting it, and it's...
Not a bad ping as well, I should point out. I think, like, maybe once or twice it went all King Crimson on me, but that was mostly playable.
I think it did to me too, so I think it's just my computer lagging, if anything. So,
oh, right. Yeah.
So, yeah. It's actually good to know that the ping isn't bad.
It gives me hope for Chivalry.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm guessing it's the same people based on the fact that they included that character in this game.
It might not be. I mean, you tend to get a lot of cross-promotion and things. I mean, like, there's a character from Nidhogg that's in Divekick now. And they're not really connected.
Fair enough.
Other than the fact that Nidhogg has a Divekick in it, so it's not, like, completely banned.
Reminds me that Killer Instinct has a Divekick outfit in it.
Yeah, I saw that. That's great.
For a character that doesn't have a Divekick.
Well,
or really any kicks.
Well, it's great because it's like Iron Galaxy, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's taking a little while because I think that's just me.
Oh, I'm already loaded.
Yep.
I might want to be just murdering things this time.
Depends on what kind of weapons you want to murder people with. You got fire explosives, shotguns, assault rifles, and melee weapons. And pistols. Although I will say Demo is probably one of the harder classes to actually level because their weapon progression is actually really shitty.
I'll tell you what, I'll stick with Medic, because I'm very close to leveling up.
I'll go for it, then.
Actually, no, I want to try something else. Try Firebug.
Firebug's fun. Got a good variety of weapons in Firebug too.
Wow.
Your starting one is a small flamethrower. Your second weapon is a shotgun that fires incendiary rounds. Your third is a big flamethrower, and your fourth is you might have to just see it.
Okay. Well, and I'm gonna try and conserve ammo.
It's a little easier with Firebug. You just, with the Calcon Burn, you can just kind of just set people on fire and then walk away. Just like give them a quick shot.
Okay. I like the dialogue. I mean, I've got this turned kind of low, but
I was actually looking in the editor for all of the at all the voice clips because every character actually has a set of weapons that are considered their favorite weapons, and they have a lot of using and wielding those specific weapons. And it's kind of interesting because some of them are not in the game yet, so you can actually like get a little preview of what they're going to add.
Nice.
Because I noticed your guy actually has two lines, or two different weapons that are bow weapons, like a crossbow.
Oh, right.
So I'm a little interested in seeing what's going on there. And he seems to also be a fan of explosives and fire.
Behind you.
There's a lot of dialogue in this game for just, you know, everything. Which, I mean, it still has a problem where you end up hearing a lot of it, like, over and over again, but they at least accounted for several situations, such as, you know, you have the ammo checks, you have health checks, you have characters telling others to stop moving so you can heal them.
I'm gonna get a medic pistol so it can shoot you.
Okay. I think, yeah, Firebug is one of those classes where you don't have a lot of variety in terms of
trench gun.
Yep, that's a shotgun that shoots fire.
Okay, I've got to get that. Also, seeing the Eiffel Tower like that, it's giving me Twisted Metal 2 flashbacks.
Yeah, right.
I'm just thinking, oh, we can go on the rooftops now.
It hasn't fallen over quite yet. It's kind of suspended. Reminds me how in Dead Rising 3, one of the random cars you can drive is a hearse, and I just feel like I'm playing Shadow every single time I see it. Oh, that's the game where you can combine, like, cars together to make, like, really weird ones, and I swear to God, some of them are Twisted Metal cars. Like, they just, you can have them shoot out missiles, or, like, acid. It's, like, weird as hell.
I wouldn't mind some, like, Fury Road Twisted Metal crossover.
Oh, yeah? Oh, man, that'd be awesome.
Like, a Warwick is basically Darkseid. Okay, I really like this, because I don't have to, like, stop to, like, empty bullets. I just go, okay, a bit of fire for you, and then I just run away.
Also, this guy that shoots fire out... he is immune to fire.
Ah. Yeah, so, figures.
But it helps out because I think at, like, max level, you become essentially immune to fire as well. So, you have this weird, like, TF2 pyro situation where neither of you can actually burn each other.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I can relate to that. I suppose that's just like TF2, time to pull out the melee weapon.
Yeah. Although, I think, in this game, that's a lot less viable because...
Yeah, they are zombies. I don't really want to do that.
Oh, I think the Firebug has, like... They all have unique melee weapons for no reason. I guess just because, why not? And, I mean, they look different. I think they're essentially the same. But, the Firebug has, like, the coolest-looking knife.
The, Oh, yeah, I didn't even look at it. Does this game... I'm just going to save up for that trench gun.
Yeah, yeah. What are you going to ask? Characters also have a lot of dialogue for just, like, situational stuff, like being in a dark area, being in a foggy area.
That's cool.
Like, there's some for rain, which I don't think is being used yet.
I keep forgetting, yeah, this is in early access, I completely forgot.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You know what the most important thing to remember is? Is there a KOF soda mod?
Unfortunately not yet, but... they went to the marketplace and I'm boycotting this game.
I'd love if they released a new KOF and like there was a promotional tie-in, like a, I don't know, Yuri hair.
Oh my god, yes.
I also like the fire just for lighting everything up so I can see what I'm doing.
Oh yeah, yeah. I think one of your skills, which is the thing, like every class actually has skills you can choose from instead of just having binary upgrades. One of your skills actually makes your Molotovs light up stuff.
Cool.
For what it's worth, also, everything you do, like killing weapons or killing with weapons of a certain class gives you experience for that class, so
cool.
Killing with a medic pistol will give medic experience. And there's also other things that you can do to get experience for a class, and a lot of them require you to be that class or, you know, use a class's weapons, but the medic one actually gives you medic experience for just for healing people, so...
I just realized another TF2 pyro parallel. I just lit up something that's invisible.
Oh, yeah.
It's like I'm spy checking. heal you a bit. I'm all loaded up.
There is, in fact, a sprint button, too.
Oh, yeah, I know. Oh, I have a shot. I didn't notice the syringe all this time.
The what?
The syringe, I never noticed it. That's why I was using the medic pistol for so much. Oh.
Oh, yeah. The syringe isn't incredibly... It's pretty ineffective. Like, it only heals 20, and it... Somebody.
Hey, what's this? Ha ha ha, treasure! Yeah, a trench gun. I don't even care if it sucks, I just love the concept. Where is it?
It's okay.
And the syringe and other healing items, they just recharge, don't they?
Yep.
That's nice. You don't have to, like, ration that out too much. I mean, this game's so fast-paced, it's really just a matter of can you heal rather than do you...
Yeah, because you can die very quickly. Especially in hard difficulties, like really strong units that melee you essentially take away half your health, so...
One thing that's throwing me off is if you press reload with a fully... that you've got... If you're fully loaded and you press reload, you do a little animation. Which is making me feel like I'm reloading every time.
A lot of neat little touches, like, what is it? If you have a melee weapon and you do that reload animation, then, you clean the blood off of it. Kind of a niche thing, but they made a really big deal out of if there's skills that make you reload faster, then it doesn't just speed up the animation, it actually has like a different animation.
Oh, that's cool.
Just kind of reload it more tactically, I suppose.
Like that thing where you get two magazines tied together and you just spin them around, stuff like that.
Right, yeah.
Hmm.
actually seen it in action because I haven't unlocked any of them yet. But
I really like the Firebug.
Oh yeah, yeah, Firebug is really good and really fun. Like, he was actually really like lame and kind of underdeveloped in the first game, but it's insanely good in this game.
Okay, I'm gonna heal myself.
The Firebug also has a really good weapon for dealing with big guys too, so it's just an all-around good class. That does no damage to him.
It knocked him around a bit. Christ, this guy's like under Splatterhouse or something.
Yeah, right?
It's like Biggie Man. I realize that reference is lost on you, but... Oh, you're not the biggest fan of Slaughterhouse.
I was just thinking of my other favorite Sega Genesis game, Predator 2.
Oh, yeah. You know, now you mention that, it's kind of... There's something kind of familiar in this game.
Soda?
It's not KOF soda.
There are no televisions showing Johnny Bravo. I'm not liking this.
Damn it. That was just the funniest thing. I don't know why it existed. It's just a two-frame animation.
Like, they could have done any dumb, like, meme GIF ever, and they chose to do that. You know?
It's
which
great.
I'm thankful for. It's like you expect the worst and you get something brilliant.
I like this classic, you know, goddamn flamethrower, just as a starting weapon.
Oh yeah.
I realize it's not the best one, but you know.
It's honestly pretty good.
Seems to be.
Now, generally people like to sit on that until they can afford the flamethrower or the final weapon. But I love the trench gun a lot, so I ended up selling mine for the trench gun early.
Oh, that's why you can sell weapons. I better do that next time.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, hello. Grenade. Molotov.
That's doing really good damage to him, actually.
Just gonna...
This guy's weak to explosions, but...
Right.
He might outrun them. Yeah, he's running way
Shit.
Too fast.
You know, I should have clarified this a bit sooner, but is there friendly fire?
No.
Thank God for that.
Yeah. Oh, there he goes. Now he's pissed off at me.
I mean, like, in Left 4 Dead, having friendly fire is valid, because it's a bit more measured. You know, you sort of do burst fire and stuff like that. This is way too hectic for me to sort of
yeah.
be careful. I'm making my way to you. Might be time to just set things on fire. Oh shit.
So I feel like it's really not necessary for me to say this, but headshots in this game mean a shitload.
Oh, yeah, that was the first thing I was doing.
Okay. I'm just saying, like, Killing Floor has always been kind of bad about that, or, like, I wouldn't say bad about it, but it's always been kind of a thing. It's like body shots, especially against anyone who's not just, like, the most basic enemy, is almost just useless.
As soon as I saw a head come off, I was like, okay, that's an important thing to do. Right, I'm gonna sell... How do I sell?
Click on the gun in the on the right, and then hit the sell button in the middle top.
Right. Okay, I now have a proper flamethrower.
Excellent.
It didn't occur to me to sell anything. Actually, I'm going to see what else I can afford. Just autofill. Oh god, that's good range.
Yeah. Essentially, it's one of your two final weapons. Either you stick with the flamethrower or the microwave.
Has iron sights, like, what's the point? I'll heal you just a tad.
Oh, that's right, I have more than 100 HP as my max. It's just the thing of the commando, I suppose.
I'm gonna stick with the trench gun until I really need the flamethrower.
Yeah, yeah, that's a good idea. Big guys.
Big guys coming in.
Crowds.
Oh, that's a
damn.
It's reloading.
So your trench gun is actually your better weapon for dealing with the flamethrower guys?
Oh yeah, of course, yeah.
It actually does decent damage to them, as your other ones don't do anything, but...
Alright, I'm gonna burn this guy.
Yeah, yeah. You got him. Okay. Oh, shit. Oh, she ate my grenades!
Don't worry, I've got another one there. Wow, this is some good fire effect! It's just filling up my screen. Oh, not see it, shit. Okay, I'm really low on health.
Yeah. Try healing you, but you're in a bad spot.
Yeah, I know.
I caught one or two.
Alright. It's gonna...
Well, I'm out of ammo. Ooh, that was a bad move on my part, too.
Whoa. God, that was close.
It's one of those ways that they send you, like, everything at once. Sometimes they kind of, like, get kind of built up and then they suddenly just unleash on you.
Oh, free ammo.
Yeah.
Is there much point to, like, closing up doors and welding them? Because things are just kind of spawning in. I mean, I'm not, like, controlling them.
Welding doors is good, like, if you find a good choke point to, they'll build up around the door, and then, like, I'll try to, like, break it down, and if you, like, get them all built up around the door, and then, like, throw an explosive at it as it goes down, you can clear out a lot of zombies that way.
Right.
It's not something we do very often, but it does have applications.
I just want to try this out.
I'll go for it.
I realize there's very little point to that. In fact, if anything, I'm just going to make them, like, all filter up together and they'll burst through.
Yeah, but then you throw a Molotov on and you'll set them all on fire immediately.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. That's the way you do it.
I'm totally gonna do that.
Just keep it up a little longer.
Yeah. Stupid zombies. What idiots. Zombies hate fire. Well, unless they're wearing, like, the fire suit.
Unless they are fire.
What's the matter, zombie? Can't get through doors? Wow, they really are all on that one side.
Yeah, okay, here comes some dudes. Let's say that was a little unusual that they were all there. Okay. Right, I have the class I can extend that slowdown. So.
I'll try keep an eye on the door.
Go ahead and just let it fall.
Yeah.
So. I think if they beat on enough, no matter how much you weld it, it actually will just go down, so.
I keep backing off before I kill those fat ones. I keep thinking they're not boomers.
Oh, they are boomers, essentially.
Oh.
If you,
So.
Yeah, if you take their heads off, they'll fall over, but if you, like, kill them, like, you shoot their bodies enough to they before they die, they will explode, and you will get poisoned.
Right, I shall not do that, then.
Yeah, essentially just pop their heads off and they're more than useful. Pretty much won't do anything.
I just remembered,
The door!
Right.
At 20.
Cool. Don't worry, I've got an eye on it. Let me just reload my flamethrower. The Pyro in TF2 actually had a Mr. Foster mask.
Excellent.
There we go.
Oh, jeez. There was a siren there and she fucking ate it up.
Oh, shit.
Okay, I think we got them. Okay, yeah, you set them all on fire, and I set a grenade on them, so.
Cousin.
Take that guy out. This guy's gonna beat up on me a little bit.
God, it's a slow reload. Shit, I'm trying to get to you. Trying to get to you.
We're going around the same direction.
Shit, my. Try and heal you up.
Take out that siren. Guess the big guy died. I don't see him anywhere. I think we saved this one.
God, I use a lot of flamethrower fuel there. I'm not even sure what's going on half the time. I'm just like, ah.
Where's our last guy? It's unusual if the last guy is staggering behind.
You know what? I'm gonna heal during this time, in case it's a particularly nasty thing. Hey, what's this? This weapon is too heavy.
Yeah,
I found a shotgun.
Weapons.
Right.
Ah, can't afford it. I can't carry it either, but then again, I got some good stuff, so. It's mostly just free money.
Cool.
Where's this dumb idiot?
You know what, this reminds me of Fallout 4. There's actually a perk you can get for situations like this will basically just point you towards the last enemy.
No. Don't tell me the game glitched up on us. It's funny, because the first game has a failsafe for this, where the last guy will just end up dying on his own. But the second game did something where when you have only a couple guys left, they start moving really fast. But since I think this guy can't get to us, how fast he moves doesn't really matter whenever he's just probably, like, running in a circle or something.
Well, let's just have a look around. I get a feeling I might let my guard down and just get ripped apart.
I don't think it's anything big. Honestly, we might just be bugged. The last guy might just be stuck somewhere.
Well, let's just search every corner.
Yeah. What's weird is I don't remember seeing that Flesh Pound die, the really big glowy dude. So, unless you killed him, I think he might have just bugged out somewhere, but...
I thought I did kill him.
Because there were two of them that round. Nothing is like this has ever happened to me before. So the fact that it's happening...
This game sucks!
Just like, it's like, what a great time for it to do with this.
I demand money for my free weekend. Wasted. They owe me 2 minutes. Do you have any options as the host?
That's a good question. I'm not sure I do. Aside of, like, just changing the map.
We haven't been out here yet.
He's in the bar getting drunk.
Oh, hello!
Who was it? Where?
It was one of those spider ones.
Where did you find him?
I don't know, out of Le Petit Chat.
Huh.
The small cat. That was weird. What the hell was he doing over there? He was like sightseeing.
Yeah, right? Like, I've never seen the Eiffel Tower.
Before I die, I have to see the Mona Lisa. Oh, I don't want to die yet. I want to see the Ark.
If you want for anything cool, now's the time to do it. But
how good is this microwave gun?
It's insanely good.
Would you say it's better than the... Is it worth getting rid of my trench gun?
Oh, yeah, definitely. If you can carry it. I don't think you can, though.
I can't. Shit.
It's either flamethrower or microwave.
It's too heavy. Yeah. I just lost my trench gun in the process. God damn it.
Yeah.
Oh, and for this guy as well. Great. I'm coming to you.
It's funny, this is the only boss in the game for a little while, so, it was always just really frustrating, actually, like, trying to win the game. Apparently his little, like, battery pack thing is actually a weak point, too.
Oh, oh shit. Oh, God. What's he doing? Get off.
He's healing. He's healing off.
Don't heal me, you fuck. I'm trying to think what he reminds me of.
Those explosives. The poison ones are not so bad, the explosives are really nasty.
I'm gonna heal you. Oh shit.
He's gonna grab me, just heal me while he's holding on to me. And loving me.
Shit.
Because he has a lot of attacks, but
you might want
to fun to fight.
I want to see if I can. I wanted to aggro him, but okay, never mind.
No, he just froze. He could just attack whoever. It's fine.
Might have. sure like this ambience.
Yeah?
Ship, yeah, I know, just...
You gotta let him grab you.
No, I don't. Get away!
Oh no. He's not gonna stop.
Leave me alone! I don't want a hug!
Throw your Molotovs at him, pray for the best.
It's a really bad time to run out of ammo. I wish I had my trench gun. Yeah, this is over. This is over. If I had my trench gun, I might still have... Ah. That was really annoying. I sold the gun I didn't know about encumbrance. I'm not saying it would have definitely killed him, but it, you know, would have been less helpless.
It's a learning experience, it's no big deal. So, what do you think?
I'm enjoying this. I'm enjoying this a lot.
It's a very good game.
But they added cosmetics, so fuck this.
Yeah, no, just... The
fuck this!
I could buy a hat, I hate this game.
These people are trying to make money. What scumbags. Why don't they make games for free?
And it's entirely because, like, oh, it's still in beta, so they can't add a marketplace. Like, well, marketplaces, or, like, the beta is kind of the place to implement these things and test them out.
Like, well, yeah, that's kind of the point. It's not like your game's been out for 5 years and then suddenly they take all your guns and say, you're not allowed these. I might have to call it quits, though.
That's fine.
I'm enjoying this a lot.
We can play some more tomorrow, I assume.
I'm sure it's a bad time to discover this, though, because I'm kind of spent a lot of money. I probably will get this.